Welcome back. My name's Dave Eling, and this is another segment of Veterans Did You Know? I'm here today with Dr. Dennis Cobbler. Dennis is a long stay in this community. He's an optometrist and really big in the Lions Club International and big in the veterans organizations. Dennis is a Vietnam vet himself, as we talked about, and came back and was instrumental in getting the Veterans Service Center program started in the state of Michigan, and especially here in Muskegon, and that was the headquarters. We were pretty lucky, I guess, to have the headquarters here, too.
Under
Vets, Inc. Was named the agency, and it was it's headquartered right here. And boy, to see the clinics were in Escanaba, Sault Ste. Marie, Traverse City, Monroe, Muskegon, and
Lapeer
was the other one, spread out there. And the intent was back then is to kind of, when the vet came in, is to kind of refer them, you know, or give them some guidance where to go. And then all of us said, you know, wait, last thing you want to hear when you go someplace is, you know, you can't get it here, but maybe go there. So we've been working pretty hard to make it a one-stop shop, if you will, and have all the services. What we put here in Muskegon is that you can come in the door and get all our services out. But it took somebody with some foresight and some initiative and some get up and go to do it. And Dennis was one of the, he was a leader. I mean, he was the chief officer there at the time. And it was walking point for us, and we appreciate all those years that you did that, Dennis. You took a lot of flack from a lot of agencies, but stood up and said, you know, it's all about the vets, and the rest is history, as they say, but Dennis was a big gun in them. And those of you who are familiar with the Veterans Memorial Park, if you drive between Muskegon and North Muskegon, you pass what was used to be called Michigan's Most Beautiful Mile, and we think it's pretty doggone close to that again, it's coming back, but you may have noticed some construction going on out there, And for years, we've been trying to bring that park up to the 20th century with lighting and electrical, and we've always made an effort to try to put Christmas decorations out there. We'd run these wires off the poles, and one would pop a circuit, and you know, half the lights would go off, and you had to get consumers out there to climb a pole to put them back on, and then people say, well, the park was really pretty for a few minutes there, and then it half went out. And then, so the Lions Club has always done the north end of the park. Had a nice display up there, and it really looked pretty. And so we as a group, on the 75th anniversary of the park, which was 2 years ago, this Veterans Day, got to brainstorm again, and Dennis said, you know, we gotta do something about this electrical problem. I don't know if it's a coincidence, but he's a guest speaker out there this year. And he said, well, I'm going to speak. I want to have people to hear what I have to say. So. We got to put some electricity in here and stuff. So Dennis, tell them what the project is at the Lions Club, married up with the vets. And
well, Dave, the biggest thing with any, excuse me, anything in the community is if it's going to be big, it's going to be bigger than any organization by itself. So Northside Lions put together an outreach to other organizations like the Vet Center and the County Council of Veterans. And I got to say right now that one of the most important guys we've got is Lupi Alviar, who is also a Vietnam vet, a very, very active in all kinds of levels of veteran service, and is a member of our Lions Club.
He sits on this Veterans Committee.
Yeah, he does.
He's here too. So, yep.
Any veteran in town that doesn't know Lupi Alviar has been out of town for a while.
Yep. And he ran employment training also.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did. He was MESC, yep. He was very good at it. So Lupi's been instrumental, and we've worked a lot with various organizations. We don't care who gets the credit for the park. It remains a veterans park, and even though the Northside Lions are very, very interested in it, it's still a veterans park. And what we have done is the Northside, as Dave mentioned, the city of North Muskegon takes the very north end and puts in some very nice lighting.
Very nice, yeah.
And then we just have concentrated over the past few years on the south end as you come across heading north. But as Dave said, we get a lot of compliments, I shouldn't say compliments, comments, yeah, about half the wire or half the lights gone. And it's very discouraging to spend all that time and money and effort.
A lot of volunteer hours
putting that together. And then to have it blank out. So the kickoff was the 75th anniversary of the park. We had had a very nice turnout. We had vendors, we had a military
state
band
display.
But the problem was is we had to have three military generators supplying the power. Now anybody that's been in the service or been around a military generator knows that it's going to take out everything as far as
noise.
It just drowns out everything. So we said enough is enough, and again, with the partnership with the veterans and the Northside Lions and the Community Foundation, we put together a plan to have the community donate dollars. They're tax deductible. It goes right to the foundation, and it goes right in. Let me just get a form here for those that are interested. It goes right into the Veterans Park Improvement Fund, check made out to Muskegon County Community Foundation. In the memo box, you would put the Veterans Park Improvement Fund. And out of that, the monies that we have received so far, we've spent a lot of it. But as Dave mentioned, the driving across the causeway, we've done a lot of trenching out there and burying wires, everything to code, everything right the way it's supposed to be. And here again is the other part of the partnership. Belasco Electrical is overseeing it. They know exactly how it's supposed to be. But the retired electrical workers from the IBEW, they're local, has been out there doing all the work along with the Lions. And they brought in their apprentice program because that is work for them on outdoor industrial. So
I don't know how many hours John spent on putting infrastructure, drawing it all out.
Oh, I know.
What service need to be here, what amperage, what this, how much
water. Yeah, we owe John a big thanks.
Yeah, right down to how many screws you need to put that plate on that thing.
Yes, he does.
And then the workers are all volunteers. Again, this is their retirees, and these are all volunteer hours. I don't know, what do we think, $50,000 or $60,000 worth of
yeah, that's what they figured there. If you were going to hire that many electricians, that's what it would be. And we've got the south end now pretty well done, including the very south point. But we really want to go up the east and west sides all the way up so that we can have power throughout. Because the Northside Lions envision that as maybe a community business or something like that. Our corporation would say, we want this part of the park
to decorate.
Yeah. And again, we don't care who gets the credit. We just want it. And quite honestly, we've had some flack about Christmas lighting and doing that in this day and age you cannot...
Politically correct?
Yeah, you got to be politically correct on everything, but the fact remains is Christmas lighting gives an opportunity to really showcase the park. If you go by there at night and it's dark, you don't think about the park. But if you go out there and see all the Christmas displays and the lighting, all of a sudden you say, there's a community that's actually moving forward. So this is, the electrical update was just the tip of the iceberg. We, as you mentioned, they call it Michigan's most beautiful mile, but anybody with good eyesight knows that's not true.
Yeah.
We got a lot of work to do, but if we care about the veterans and we care about their memory, we care about their service, then we should care about the park. And that's what I'm looking for, and the group is looking for, is people in the community that may not have the time to volunteer hours in the park, or maybe even if they're not a veteran, if they care enough about the service that veterans do, they'll make that donation to the community foundation. So the people who are still capable of working and still really want to get it done can get it done. But again, this is a community effort. All the great ideas in the world are absolutely worthless if the community doesn't buy into it.
Well, those of you who are familiar with the Vets Park, you know there's a trail through there we put in there, and that's how we did it. We discussed how can we put that Vets trail through there, and we sold individual markers off, one at a time, and there's over 3,140 something markers out there, and it's almost a mile and three quarters of walkway, and it's all paid for by one marker at a time.
Yep.
One family at a time, or one loved one said to honor their vet. They went out there and they did that, and you know, the whole project we're looking at is probably what we always figure $500,000 or $1 million, something like that.
Well, the
totally, I mean, the whole big picture, putting that back where it is, and that's a lot of money if you, you know, but if you say it real fast, it goes by pretty quick. But you don't have it, it's a lot of money. But what was the term you used? If each person gave, if 100 vets,
the electrical part was about $100,000.
Yeah.
And we had already had 20 some thousand in the thing, so We were looking for 800 people to put $100 on the table. We got 170,000 people in Muskegon County.
Yep.
And that's the way you look at
14,000 vets.
And 14,000 vets. And what you look at is you divide up the pie by that number, and it comes out to be a silly, like 65 cents a person. And I am a strong believer that if I can't
give 65
if you can't get 65 cents per person
for the vets
and
this community,
yep,
you
go,
the
wow,
park belongs to the community, it's ours. So we got to take another break here real quick, and we'll do that, and we'll be back in just a few minutes to pick up where we left. We've got some other stuff to talk about, so you're welcome.